Hey guys, welcome to this episode of Side Order. I'm Chris Elwood.
I'm Aidan Belazaire, and we're here at the new gourmet grilled cheese bar called Northern Soul. Although it doesn't look like it, it's absolutely freaking freezing out here.
So cold.
So we're gonna go and defrost and eat some grilled cheese.
Let's do it.
Right. So I'm here with the man behind Northern Soul, Dan Place. We've managed to steal him away from the kitchen temporarily. Dan, the whole place has a great vibe.
Yeah.
You do great food.
Thank you.
Where did it all start? How did you start everything here?
The honest answer is late night sessions coming in, and it's just two skillets and grilled cheese after a night out, and that's purely where it came from.
Right.
We've been in the pipeline for about a year and a half. We had a wicked trip to New York. And obviously home with the grilled cheese, brought it back, tweaked it, had a little play around with it, and the rest is history really. Yeah, so we're just trying to offer ultimate comfort food, what people want to eat at a good price, and don't want to take it too seriously.
I mean, why do you think there isn't really many grilled cheese places around? Because it's awesome.
I mean, for me, I don't, you know, the English version is, remember the old Breville's?
Yeah, those triangle
things. And cheese and beans. Mm. Now, that will be coming on the menu at some point. That's what I grew up on. There's no way we want to discredit that type of thing and conventional toasties. But what we do is we have a little bit of a twist. We're kind of using artisan products with our twist on the grill. So we're getting that kind of killer produce. And offering the gourmet version on there. It's not just a classic cheese, ham, you know, we're offering, you know, sourdough breads, pulled pork versions,
yeah.
So we're taking bits of genres from street food and then mixing them into our concepts of grilled cheese.
Sweet. And did you have like another restaurant before this place, or you pretty much took the inspiration in New York, came home and just knew what you had to do?
This is my first venture into food, so it was just at the point where I wanted to come in. The street food is just about to boom. It's this food I absolutely adore. You can keep your restaurants and all that. I like going around shacks, you know, market stalls,
yeah.
You know, guys that are like-minded with me and they don't take themselves too seriously. I just want to knock out good, honest food at a decent price and enjoy what we're doing.
Well, judging by how busy it's been, it looks like you're not the only person who likes it. Yeah, as I mentioned before, the vibe, like you have the soul music kicking out,
yeah.
And then that makes people look in, and then they come in and they smell the food. And I mean, is that all part of it as well?
Listen, first and foremost, it's Northern Soul, keep the faith, man. It's that's as serious as it is. The rare beats are just snapping necks on the street. They're bringing the people in. There's no magic to that. It's all about the music. It's just that beat and the noise coming onto the street, followed up by the smell wafting out and people coming in hitting grilled cheese. That's literally it. That's the secret sort of doing. There is no secret.
Nice. Smooth. Well, I'll let you get back to the kitchen.
Lovely.
We're going to head over to Chris, who's in the kitchen with Kevin, who's going to whip us up one of the signature dishes, the soul.
Yeah, you can have whatever you want, mate. Grills are on.
That's a great deal. Let's do it.
We want to talk a little bit about the actual making of the sandwich, if that's cool with you, Kev.
That's absolutely fine.
What bread do you use, if you don't mind me asking?
We use sourdough bread. It's 24-hour proof, so we have to basically follow the order through the day before kind of thing, otherwise we just won't get the sandwich.
And I was talking before you about the cheeses you use, so like it's different, isn't it, every week? You use different cheeses, so...
Yeah, we've got a regular local supplier that we use, but it all depends on what kind of deal we can get, so obviously we can then pass that down to our customers, really. So yeah, basically it could change from week to week.
Is there any particular cheeses that you kind of go with? Like, is it like a cheddar or?
We do have a three cheese blend that we regularly kind of try to stick to, but obviously if I was to tell you that, then I'd have to kill you, so.
Understandable. Now, obviously your menu isn't just grilled cheese sandwiches. You've got some other stuff on there as well. What else is on there? Like your specials and other things of that
Yeah,
nature?
We do a mac pot special, which is basically a pot of mac and cheese topped off with 9-hour pulled pork.
Ooh.
Our barbecue pulled pork, should I say, and then that gets served with garlic cheese bread.
Method. How do you make your grilled cheese in this place? What do you do?
Well, start off, obviously, you get two pieces of sourdough bread. We then coat that with softened butter. Then we flip one side over. Then literally you put your three cheese blend in. And this is just a bit of the basic sole. And then depending whether you like Worcestershire sauce on it, onions, tomatoes, because you can have additions to that. And then obviously you put the top onto the bread and onto the grill it goes.
Amazing. How long is it on the grill for?
About 2 minutes on each side kind of thing. But yeah, you're looking at about 4 minutes for each sandwich.
And have you got any plans for the future in this place? I noticed you've got a sign on the door next door. What's going on there?
Yeah, we're actually looking to expand next door. So nice. There'll be killer beets with even bigger, cheesier treats. So yeah.
Nice.
Perfect.
So you got barbecue pulled pork with some mac and cheese below here, and this is garlic bread, didn't you? Use the ends of the bread for making the garlic bread as well, so I think we should give this a bit of a go.
The
ladies
if you
first.
Can see, if you can see inside the pulled pork, which is a huge amount of pulled pork at that, sits on top of the mac and cheese there, which is all creamy, cheesy, and absolutely delicious.
That's shocking.
I know, right?
Terrible.
Let's do it. Jump in. Watch this.
Jumping in. I need to get a little bit of both bits, you see, I don't just want to get a mac and cheese bit.
Oh my god. Some more.
Oh my god. That is so indulgent. I love that.
It's creamy, it's oozy. it's not too sweet, because the pulled pork then balances it out.
Yeah.
You know? Which, again, that isn't too sweet either, because I hate it when pulled pork, it just tastes like sugar and meat.
Yeah,
but that doesn't, you can taste the meat.
Yeah, you've got the meat taste in there as well. Pulled pork, it's amazing.
Let's try a bit of this.
That didn't really work. Should have forked it on me.
Oh man. It's crunchy. The garlic's there, but it's not too strong. It's like an essence, if you know what I mean.
Essence of garlic?
Essence of garlic.
Should be the name of a vampire film.
But it's nice, it lends to the pulled pork and the mac and cheese as well, so everything works together, which is a great combination, you know?
Okay, boys, you've got your chocolate loaf, which is Hershey's influence from America, finished with a bit of cream.
Nice.
And then there's a South American influence there with dulce leche, which is like a caramel milk, finished with a bit of cute fudge and a squirt of toffee sauce.
Damn.
Shit.
Everything you just said sounded like porn films.
You know, I like milkshakes when they have chunks of something in it, so either it's cookie or fudge or whatever, but these, if I just grab this one here, look at... There's a chunk, that is like half a piece of fudge right there.
Cheers.
It's so thick, you think you're gonna like rip your cheeks off sucking it up.
I feel like I'm having dessert before my main.
I'm fine with that. I am fine with that. Jalapeno, what was it?
Jalapeno.
Chorizo, you just said. Chili chutney and heatwave Doritos. And the three cheese blend. And the delicious bread. Oh.
Mate, just... I think we should cheers this as well, you know. Are you going to go for that one first?
I might as well. Cheers.
Cheers, guys. I know this might sound like a weird analogy that someone said before when we were talking, but it's like biting into an armadillo. It's so crunchy on the outside and like juicy goodness on the inside.
Absolutely.
Love it. That's amazing.
Oh, this is so good. The Doritos, they're not completely soggy or anything like that, so you still got a bit of crunch to them, but more so it's just the flavour comes through. Then you've got the jalapenos in there as well, which I love heat anyway. And the chorizo, that blends with the cheese, which is always a great combination anyway. Any spicy meat and cheese is awesome.
If you want to get some of this original, some of the, you know, is going to sum this place up, then obviously that one's the one to go for.
So this one's, the signature dish, the sole. Oh, man.
What was that noise?
Dan suggested mix it up with the red slaw and a bit of
Dill pickle.
Dill pickle.
Or dickle. You know what that is? You are right. I can see exactly why they come as a compliment now. Mm.
Boys, 4 cases a week of that.
Mm. That last time I was here, I had loads of that stuff. And garlic and chilli sauce.
For anyone who's worried, it's got a nice warmth to it in the flavour, but it's not too hot, so it's not going to blow your face off or anything. Mm. And again, it's all about layering things up here, so... You come to Northern Soul. First of all, you come for the music, okay? You come in for the vibe. You come in for the politeness and the awesomeness of the staff, who love what they do. That's really important. It bleeds all the way through to the food, to the final product.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Even, it doesn't matter if it's busy or if there's no one here, same service, same quality and the attention to detail. Then when you do try something like this, you can taste that quality, you know, from the ingredients, basically, from the bread to the cheese, to the special cheese blend, to the condiments that they serve with it, to the shakes and the sides, all the way down to the signature dish, and then all the other specials that appear fortnightly. It's just top service, A plus every step of the way, you know?
Yeah, this place is amazing. Yeah, love everything we've had on the menu. It's been great.
Yeah, and that's why we love it so much and why we continue to come.
Can you shut up, Aiden, so we can eat, please?
Right. But you need to know that how good this place is.
Indeed.
We've told you, now that's enough filming, it's time for us to eat and enjoy it ourselves.
Rare beats and cheesy treats.